Hello, this is Tony Kaplan, and for my technology research paper, I studied quantum dots. Quantum dots are tiny semiconductor crystals. This means that these particles can either conduct or resist electricity depending upon the temperature and purity of the semiconductor. Quantum dots range in size from 2 to 10 nanometers. Because of their diminutive size, the physics of these particles is governed by quantum mechanics. The size, energy levels, and emission color of quantum dots can be precisely controlled, which makes them extremely useful in a variety of applications. One of the unique properties of quantum dots is that their emission color depends on their size, not their material. The bigger the quantum dot, the larger the wavelength and the smaller frequency it will emit. The color of light is dependent on its wavelength, so this means that the largest nanocrystals will emit red light and the shortest will emit blue, with all the other colors appearing in between. This color-changing phenomenon is the result of different band gaps between different size quantum dots. The band gap of a semiconductor is the energy required for its electrons to enter an excited state. Small dots have large band gaps, so they require a lot of energy to enter an excited state. This high energy input results in a high energy frequency, meaning a smaller wavelength of light. This is why smaller dots emit light towards the blue end of the spectrum, and larger dots emit light towards the red end of the spectrum. Quantum dots can be created in a few different ways, but in very simple terms, they are generally made by a chemical reaction in a solution resulting in solid nanocrystals. The chemicals are combined over heat and begin to react around 255 degrees Celsius. The length of the reaction affects the size of the crystals. As soon as the mixture is removed from the heat, the reaction will end and the particles will retain their size and color. Many different semiconductor materials can be used to create quantum dots, such as cadmium selenide, cadmium sulfide, lead selenide, lead sulfide, indium arsenide, and indium phosphide. All of these combinations include heavy metals, which are regulated by the FDA. This makes it difficult and potentially dangerous to market products with quantum dots, and limits the possibility of biological imaging using quantum dot technology. The most promising options so far are copper indium sulfide crystals with a zinc sulfide protective shell. So why am I telling you about quantum dots? Their unique properties are useful in many different applications, from medical imaging, energy-efficient lighting and displays, to photovoltaic cells. Quantum dots will emit light through photoluminescence or electroluminescence. This means that solutions of quantum dots glow when stimulated by ultraviolet light or electricity. Quantum dots are ideal for use in solar cells because they can be synthesized at a variety of different sizes fairly easily. Using many different size semiconductor particles in the photocell means that it'll be able to absorb energy from a greater portion of the light spectrum than current photocells. Quantum dots can also be used for vivid, energy-efficient displays and lighting. Some companies are already using quantum dots to provide bright, backlit LCD screens, but soon quantum dot-only displays could be a possibility. These displays can be created in sheets, allowing for flexible screens and vibrant colors. Quantum dots are being used experimentally in medical imaging as highly accurate fluorescent tags. As previously mentioned, quantum dots are created using tiny heavy metal-based crystals. There is significant concern about how these tiny particles of potentially toxic metals will travel, collect, and decay within the body. A study in 2013 concluded without any evidence of toxicity in mice and monkeys, although after 4 months, the mice showed an accumulation of particles in the spleen and liver. The monkeys' organs did not show any accumulation or side effects, but there is still a lot of research to be done before we see quantum dots become a staple of medical imaging. The commercial demand for quantum dots is expected to grow significantly in the next decade. According to Allied Market Research, we can expect to see demand for quantum dots grow by almost 30% by 2020. Companies and researchers continue to explore the possibilities for quantum dots. These particles are being studied for their possible applications in quantum computing, biosensors, transistors, diode lasers, and battery technologies.